Hey there guys, and welcome back to Let's Play Final Fantasy 13. In the last episode, we continued through the Yaschas Massif, and we completed the Sea Stone Mission 5, and slayed the Mark. Also, we opened up a couple treasure balls, and gained a little bit of CP. So I'm up to about 52,000 CP, but before I go spending it, I want to collect a little bit more. Alright, so we're making excellent progress. We have most of the stuff done in this optional area of Grand Pulse. There's only a little bit more to go. So on this episode, we're going to be finding Sea Stone number 6 and completing the mission. And then after we complete the Sea Mission 6, we're going to complete Sea Mission 7, which is just further up from the 6th Waystone, or the 6th Sea Stone. And after we complete Mission 7, we can finally get out of this place. Alright, so whenever you're ready, go ahead and head north. By the way, we're in the Ascendant Scarp area. So let's go ahead and take out the enemies right in front of us for some CP.
And I was just getting started.
Alright, so after massacring the munchkins, shortly up ahead the path will split. Now earlier we took the right path in order to get to the mission number 4, or number 3, the Sea Stone mission number 3. So that was the right path. Now we're going to take the left path, which is new to us. So go ahead and take the left path now and jump up a couple logs. And we're going to have to take out a group of enemies.
Hardly worth the effort.
Alright, so after you clear them out, go ahead and continue down the path. And further up ahead, there'll be some more stones that you have to jump over. And then even more stones. And logs. On the other side, you'll have to fight two large clans, which could prove to be a very difficult battle.
Eat this! keep a cool head.
Eat it!
Thanks.
That was a pretty long battle, and I don't think it's really worth the CP, so if you want, you can skip that battle. It's not really worth it. But further up ahead, there'll be a save point on the left, and as you can see, the path will split. Now, either way you take, you'll end up at the same place because they join together further up. However, we're going to make a complete circle around so that we can kill all the enemies to get save up CP, as well as see if there's any items in the vicinity. So let's go ahead and kill the enemies right in front of us. Alright, so after taking them out, let's go ahead and take the left path first. And let's take care of the first group of enemies that we come to. We're gonna do a big circle around, starting from the left side.
New strategy.
It'll be okay. Keep it together.
You're nothing.
It'll be okay.
Thanks.
After clearing them out, continue along the path, checking for treasure along the way. Wait, was there a treasure ball over there? No, no treasure. And further up, the path will join together. So go ahead and jump up the rocks. Let's take care of the Gremlin Squad. Or the Munchkin Squad. Taking care of them. Let me quickly check to make sure I didn't miss any treasure balls down here. And nope, there's nothing down here that you can get. So when you jump up top, go ahead and backtrack. And let's take the left path. And here you can find a group of enemies guarding a treasure ball.
It's a target. As if there was any doubt.
Alright, so after clearing out them enemies, you can open up the nearby treasure ball they were guarding for a mythical bangle. Very nice. Let's go ahead and put that onto Fang. Or actually, let's put that onto Vanille. Because it increases your maximum HP by 300. And then you can equip Fang with a gold bangle. So that'll help out a little bit. Continue following back the same path, and you'll find another group of enemies.
Ready for the next fight.
Alright, so after you take care of them, let me quickly make sure that there's no more treasure balls. And then back at the entrance, you'll be at the starting area. So I'm gonna quickly kill these guys and then we're gonna move on. Now notice how we've already fought these guys.
Keep the enemy
but
off
I'm
balance.
Simply refighting them so that we can get more CP. Because there's a very hard fight coming up, and if you're underleveled, you're gonna get destroyed. So target make sure target. That you're fighting all enemies for CP.
Hardly worth the effort.
Alright. So after taking them out again, go ahead and backtrack the same way that you came from. Because if you take the left path, which is the fast path we originally took, all the monsters have respawned anyways. Well, let's go ahead and kill him for CP. The next sea stone is right around the corner, so we should be able to take care of the next sea mission all in this episode. It won't take no longer than 10 minutes, hopefully.
Ha!
getting some very nice CP coming in. So we'll be able to spend all of our Crystarium points in order to develop our characters and make them a whole lot stronger. And the final battle, let's go ahead and take out these munchkins. Or nah, we ain't even gonna worry about the munchkins. Let's just keep going. Now that the paths have rejoined together, if you continue along the path, you'll see a destination marker at the end. So let's go ahead and take out this next group of munchkins. Get them out the way. Alright, so after clearing them out the way, continue along the path. And that should have been the final set. Shortly up ahead, you'll see some ruins in the distance. And this is the next area. It's very small though, it's only a little couple squares on the map.